When you think of coding, what's the first thing that comes to mind? Computers, softwares, letters, computers. Well, guess what? There's a whole subculture of musicians that make music using coding, and they do it live in front of your face. This scene is called the Algorave scene. You're probably wondering, well, Devin, why the hell would you do that? Why wouldn't you just play an instrument? Well, I'll tell you. In this video, we're gonna answer that question, and we're gonna talk to people that are in the Algorave scene. So buckle up. So let's start at chapter one. What is Algorave?
The term Algorave was kind of made as like a joke.
This is DJ Dave, a dedicated Algorave artist who makes all her music through coding.
They thought it was funny to be like, oh, we're live coders and we're doing like algorithms and rave. We're gonna just put the words together. Like it wasn't really meant to be taken seriously or used in a serious context. But once it started blowing up, that like joke kind of thing didn't carry on and it's just used very seriously now. The Algorave scene is literally the most inspiring scene that I've ever been a part of. Every time we do something together, every time we have a meetup or a show, I leave just being so energized about like making music and like growing my knowledge around live coding. It's so awesome.
What stands out the most to me about the Algorave scene is the live experience of watching someone make music by using letters and numbers and commands and stuff. As music becomes something that you can make completely virtually, the question of what are we watching when we go to a live show becomes ever more apparent. You could transpose your production into something that can be played by live instruments. You could slap the MIDI pad on a table and have a freaking, I don't know. Having a captivating visual for a live music performance is so, so important. And it can be hard to really find what that is as music becomes more electronic. Imogen Heap talks about this a lot in her demo for these freaking gloves you wear that you control the sounds you make by just moving your body. Roll the clip.
This, for instance, this, if I wanted to bring up the reverb, what I'd have to do is I'd have to do that. Okay, that's not very exciting, is it? So if I have that like that, you can't even see what I'm doing. So I could be doing my email for all you know. The PIN code to happiness. Access denied.
So I asked DJ Dave about her experience playing some live freaking shows.
In a bunch of my shows, I've recruited artists that I know personally to make me some videos that I could play behind my code while I perform. And I've had some other people I know that do like video game design, do live visuals for me during shows. There's so many fun things that you can do that naturally integrate with the concept and like the vibe of live coding. In most of my shows, I actually don't build the songs from scratch. I've done like, I think 2 live streams that I've done, like built them from scratch. And I know a lot of live coders that do that. But for the stuff that I do, it makes the most sense for me to build it beforehand and then just edit it live. But yeah, every show ends up being unique because I'm changing things live. I don't remember exactly what I did last time, even if it was like the best show I've ever had. I'm like, I don't remember what I did. Like, I didn't record it. That's kind of my process live, I guess.
So, you want to give us a little sneak peek of how you make music? I'm going to make up a drum beat or something.
Okay. So, this is my code environment that I work in. What you're looking at here, like this list right here, is like all the samples that I'm going to use. I just like to line them up at the top so that I can easily call on them. And all those samples come from Logic, pretty much. I just like pull them from like different drum things or whatever. This is a little line that basically just like tells the program to like accept what I'm about to do. It'll make like the pattern thing make sense, and that'll also make sense in a little bit. This is obviously the BPM, which is I love a 130 BPM, so that's what we're gonna rock with today. And then this up here, I call it a metronome. It's basically just a way to, when I'm cueing things in, this will also make more sense when I start coding stuff, but when I'm like cueing and stopping different loops, it'll basically just like snap to that metronome. So it'll like all line up, instead of if I didn't have that and like didn't tell it to listen to the metronome, it'd like come in randomly. That's what we're starting out with. I usually start out with something like this when I'm doing a beat, just because then everything's laid out and I can just like make the patterns and not have to worry about anything else. There's a lot of different ways to approach a SongPsych session and like how you make stuff. I do everything in a live loop, what that is called, which basically just means that once you run the code, it's going to loop over and over and over, and you can cue it and stop it live. So you can like be playing something and then like have like 3 loops playing, and then you stop one of the loops and you can bring it back in, and you could just manipulate it live. And since I do a lot of like live performances, that makes the most sense for what I do. So I'm gonna do live. I'm gonna call it kick. I'm gonna start with the kick drum. And then I'm telling it to sync to the metronome. Let's do, I'm gonna say sample kick, which is going to call in this kick sample. And then I'm going to say if pattern. So basically, when I play this, these X's and dashes here are like a drum pattern. So anywhere that's an X is like a hit, and then anywhere that's a dash is a like a rest. So it's going to sound like this. I'm going to do a little clap. So that's kind of what that could sound like, you know.
Wow.
I don't know if you can hear that, but I made it do a little snare, a little cymbal roll. I'm very familiar with the numbers at this point because I code drum beats like every day. Sometimes I like want to start a project off in Sonic Pi and like just code the whole project. And sometimes it just feels more natural to like make music on Logic or like with a real instrument. If I'm starting from a Logic session, I'll just like find the sounds that I like and like kind of make them in there or like get started in there. And then I'll bounce all the individual samples, like just a little like one snare, one kick, like something like that. And I'll bounce it over to Sonic Pi and then just put it into like a drum beat structure. And then I can edit it from there.
But Devin, how the hell can I do this? Well, I'll tell you, there's tons of softwares out there that you can make music with by using live code. Some of them are even free. The software DJ Dave uses is called SongPsych, and it's free. Anyone can do it.
Anyone.
And I had the pleasure of speaking with the founder of SongPsych, Sam.
Hi. My name is Sam Aaron, and I created SongPsych, which allows you to code music live. I created SongPsych to allow anyone, especially those new to programming, to have a creative experience with code, and to give them the tools to hopefully express themselves in new ways. Music has always been deeply interesting to me, and I remember as a child even learning to code music using a language called BASIC and a computer called the Spectrum 48K. And I can make it make simple beeps and melodies and program it to do simple pictures and lines. The standout aspect of SongPsych is it focused on beginners and making it easy to get started. It was designed in schools with teachers to teach computer science, but has also been used to teach music, production, composition and performance. So really it's a tool designed for anyone to get started.
What? The Algorave scene, especially in America, is still super small, but it's only growing. It's definitely different from sitting down with a guitar or making a song with Logic or Ableton. I just think it's really cool to see what's underneath the computer-generated music, and that's what makes Algorave so special. You get to see that, and you can see people do it live. What? This is a really exciting new way to make music, and it's definitely worth paying attention to. So yeah, you should get into the Algorave scene. Freaking check out DJ Dave's music. She's dope. Her socials are cool. She posts some cool stuff on TikTok. And go check out SongPsych because Sam did it. And if you want to learn even more about Algorave, I'll link some resources in the description. Thanks. What do you want me to talk about next? Leave a comment or else.